Okay, today I will wrap up the selection decision statements. First, I would like to repeat quickly what we have done for the selection statements. First, we introduced the if statement. Here we have the condition. If the condition is true, we execute the first statement after the condition. We talk about the conditions. Remember that last time we have talked about the relational operators and the logical operators. Here we basically get an input from the user and compare with zero. If the number is greater than zero, we put this message onto the screen. So this is the basic usage of the selection statement. According to a condition, we will execute this statement or not. We have this example, remember. So we get two grades from the user and then find the average. If the average less than 50, we just print out that unsuccessful. Here is the flow chart. In that flow chart, we get the inputs, right? And then we have the calculation, the average, and then we have the decision point here. The condition is average is less than 50. If it is true, we print out unsuccessful. But if it is false, we did nothing but stop the program. Here is the code. You might remember from last week. I will not go to the details, but I will just talk about it. So here you see that we have the variable declarations, we have the input, we have the calculation, and here we have the selection statement. If this is the condition, if the condition is correct, the first statement after the condition, the first statement after the condition will be executed if it is true. If it is false, we just continue with the next statement. Okay. In the if-else statements, now we have two options depending on the condition truth value. Basically, if the condition is true, we will execute statement one. But if the condition is false, we are going to execute the statement two. Here, at this point, I would like to show you a simple example on the compiler. Here basically we have the grade and we compare the grade 50. So I just assigned the grade initial value as 49. And now I compared grade with 50. If the grade is less than 50, what I am going to do? I am going to do first statement after the grade. So first grade is less than and blah, blah. So let me run this code. Okay, now put this together. So we have the grade 49. We compare grade value with 50. If it is less than 50, which is correct, then on the screen I see the first statement, then 7, 8, and 9 statements onto the screen. Any questions so far? Okay. Now, if I change here, let me do like that. Now, if it is 59, what I am going to see on the screen? The first statement or not? First, 7, 8, 9. Which statements I am going to see? Yes, bravo, Bora. So it's gonna be only 7, 8, 9. Why? Because now the grade is 59 and the condition is false. So I cannot execute the first statement, but I have to continue with the rest of the program, 7, 8, and 9. Now, let me put the else here. And let me copy this statement and print here. Let me change the number. Okay, now what's gonna be the output for that program? So the grade is 59. Do you think that grade is less than 50? False. So what's gonna be output? 2, 7, 8, 9. Do you have any question? Now we have this exercise, this one, and we talk about the compound statements. After the compound statements, we have seen this nested if. And in here, we have solved this one. And now we are at this exercise. Do you have any questions from this exercise? No questions. Okay, it's great. So I will go over quickly what we have done. We have the include statement. We have the begin and end of the program. So we have the variable declarations. Here we have the input. So these inputs are the two numbers as given here. Okay. So we will just get the first number and the second number, but we want to divide the first number with the second number, but we have to check the if the second number is zero or not, because you cannot divide by zero. How can we do? I use this condition. If number is two, then printf division zero is not allowed. Else, now pay attention that here we have the compound statement. In that compound statement, we have the calculation, because we are sure that num is not zero and num2 is not zero. So we have num1 over num2 in the result, and we print the result and finish. So we can solve this question by applying the get the numbers, divide the numbers to the second one. If the num2 is zero, display an average. Otherwise, output to result. Any questions?
Yok hocam.
Okay. Here we have the already seen the nested if. So remember that nested if means that we have a if statement here. You see that? And we have the else part of that statement. So it's just the if else statement. But nested if means that we could have another if statement, either this part, in this part between if and else, or we can have this part. So in these two parts, we can have probably another if else statement, either this part or this part. So once we have this if, another if, let's say white if here, you see that we have another if statement here. Or we could have another if statement, yellow here, if, and here. So if we have these kind of statements, if statements inside another if statement, we call this nested if statements. Now compare this with the right side. Okay, and pay attention that in the right side, we have the one if statement here. And inside that if statement, else part, we have another if statement goes like that. Okay, so in that else part, we have if else statement here. So it's called nested statements. And in the exams, we mostly ask nested statements. In the real life, you will face nested statements a lot. It is very, very common to see nested statements here. So what is the problem here? The question is that given two numbers, display the smaller one onto the screen. So we need to get two numbers and compare these numbers with each other and print out the result, if they are one greater than the other or not. Now, let's go over this. So we have the variable declaration. We have the input, num1, num2. Now we have the comparison here. So if num1 is less than num1, num2, you are saying that num1 is the smaller one. Otherwise, you are putting this one onto the screen, saying that num2 is the smaller one. But assume that what happens? If I enter here as the num1 value 3 and num2 value as 3 as well, what's gonna be output? The output will check that num1 is less than num2? No. So it will go to the as part and print out the num2. Num2 is 3. Do you think that the code works correctly? Because this code displays the smaller one. Do you think that 3 is the smaller one? No, because 3 is equal to 3. So there is a mistake in that code. How can we fix this mistake? By using a nested if. So first check that if num1 is less than num2. If num1 is not less than num2, because 3 is not less than 3, then you have to check num2 is less than num1. Again, 3 is not less than 3. So you have to continue with the else. In that else part now, we are gonna printing out 3. So providing 3 in that code, you will see on the screen, they are equal. Now it is corrected. Any questions?
Now,
we are continuing with this example. Here we can use the nested loops. In real life, you will face many times this kind of nested loops. So assume that you are given the speed of the wind, and then you are gonna display the category. By looking at this table, if the speed is less than 25, you are gonna put not a strong wind. How can we do? As usually we do, by beginning including the standard input output, then we have the main here and end of the program. So you have to write this thing first. After that, you have to write the variable declaration, which one we have only the speed here. So I put the double speed. And then we need to take care of the input here. We just ask the user to enter the speed value, and we use the double placeholder to the address of speed. After that, we are at the point to compare the speed with the category here. Now, if speed is less than 25, we are here, right? Then we are gonna print not a strong wind. However, if the speed is not less than this, we have to continue with these as, and we have to check this condition. If this condition is correct, now we are sure that if we are here in the blue point, we are sure that speed is not less than 25. Am I right? If you are at this point, you are sure that speed is not less than 25. Am I right?
Evet hocam.
Evet hocam.
Okay. So if it is like that, I can only check if the speed is less than 39. So if it is like that, I am sure that the speed here is between 25 and 39. Because I already checked 25 before and else part. Otherwise I wouldn't be here. Okay, let me continue then. Here we have gonna print out the strong winds. But if the speed is not less than 39, we have to jump to the else part. Okay. Here we are gonna this else part. And in this else part, I am only checking the 55. Why? Actually, on the table, I see that it is between 39 and 55. But if I am at this point, I am sure that it is not less than 25. It is not less than 39, because else, it should be greater than 39. But now I am checking if it is less than 55. So here, between. So it goes like that until here. Pay attention to this point. In this point, after these else, I don't have any if. Why? Because I am sure that if I arrive this point, I know that the speed is not less than 72. The speed is not less than 55. The speed is not less than 39. The speed is not 25, less than 25. So I am sure that all these are false, right? All of them is false because I have the else part. Now I am sure that speed is greater than 72. 2. Because the last condition, look at the last condition here, less than or equal to 72. So I can print the type or the category of the wind as hurricane and finish. So in this kind of examples, the nested loops occurs many times in real life, but many, many times. So in the exams, expect that the nested loops will be asked. Any questions?
Yok hocam.
No questions. Here is the another exercise continuation. Now, I can do something like that. If can we remove the nested loops here? The question is that can we remove the nested loops? I'm sorry. Oops. Nested if statements. Can I remove the nested if? Yes. How can I do? Basically, I can go and delete these else parts. Okay? Look. I can delete these else. Now, how it works now? First of all, do you think that there is a nested if? Any nested if? There is no nested if because each if is just one statement and they are not connected. So remember the definition of the nested if. If one if inside another if, true part or false part. Let's check that if it is like that or not. So you can go over and check that. This if statement begins here and finish here. And the next statement, if statement begins here and finish here. So do you think that the second if statement is part of the first if statement? True or false? No. Okay, so it's not inside. So it's not nested. All others are also not nested. So how it works? Do you think that it will correctly output the result?
Hayır hocam.
Okay, let's check. Bravo. So let's check. Assume that we enter the speed as 13. So you have to check these first. Do you think that the 13 is less than 25?
Evet. True.
So on the screen you are gonna see, on the screen you are gonna see that not a strong wind, but you have to continue because there is no else. So do you think that 13 is less than 39? Yes. Evet. So you are gonna see this output as well. Then it goes like that until this statement. So you will see all the statements onto the screen because they are not nested anymore. So the code is not correct. How can you fix this code?
Switch.
No, no. Without
adding switch case, maybe.
Pardon me?
Switch case, maybe.
No, no. Before that. So actually the conditions are incorrect. Do you see that? There is only one condition, but actually we have two conditions, right?
Yes.
So we have to check the conditions. Let's assume this. Let me go back a little bit. Now, if it is 13, I have to print out this, and it is sure, right? We have to print out this. Okay, but for the second one, what is the mistake here? I am only checking if it is less than 39, but I have to check that if it is between 25 and 39, how can we fix this error? By creating a compound condition. So remember, compound conditions are created by using the logical operators or and operators. So basically, I can write this condition like that. Speed is greater than, and here notice that in mathematics, and equal to 25 and speed less than 39. and put the if here. Okay. Now we can create this condition. Now this condition has two parts. Speed must be greater than or equal to 25, and at the same time, speed must be less than 39. Now it works, right? So these conditions here, pay attention to that. All the conditions here, this one, this one, this one must be updated, plus I have to put for the hurricane a new condition. What should be that hurricane condition now? What should be the hurricane condition? Hurricane condition.
Greater than 70.
Bravo. Speed greater than 72. Now fixed. So you have to fix these conditions according to these. So for example, let's say that whole gale. So I have to put here 55 and speed 72. Okay. So for what about gale? I have to do what? So for the gale, how can I fix this? By writing this condition. How? So for the gale, look at here. It must be greater than 39 and less than 55. Okay, so you have to update these conditions because they are not anymore nested. So if they are not nested, they have the full condition. But if they are nested, you are sure that the below or the above conditions are already checked. Any questions? Here you see the answer on the left side that I also put onto the previous slide. Here, there is no nested loop, but every condition must be checked fully because you cannot depend on the above if, because there is no as connection. So you have to come to this if, all right? Which one is easy for you? This nested solution?
Nested one.
Or the without nested? Actually, I think the nested one is easier because the conditions are simpler, right? The conditions are simpler. But here, if you don't use the nested structure, then you have to sure that each if statement has the full condition.